Hi, I'm Stan, I play guitar in Brutus.
I'm Peter, I play bass in Brutus.
And you're listening to
Total Rock.
Or of Total Rock, year on air with the lovely guys of Brutus, Stan and Peter. How are you guys doing? Thank you very much for joining me.
Thanks for having us. Yeah, I'm doing fine.
Yeah. We're fine, yeah, thank you.
Very excited. I saw you a couple of times already over the years. Started at Rock 'Em Ring, I believe, last year. Still enjoying the sounds of Unison Live. And I feel like so much is coming up in the future after a really busy year with tours. There was also a deluxe version that added a few more tricks. What is coming up next? I feel like you just told us that it's going to be really difficult to see you in 2025 on a stage.
Yes.
So share some surprises. What's in plan for you guys?
Oh, not real surprises, actually. Yeah. We have a lot of festivals during the summer. And we have one more tour coming up starting 13th of September until halfway of October, I think, 15th.
In the US.
In the US. We're going to tour with Architects. And that's, I think, one of the last big things this year. And
one closing show in Brussels, because we had the feeling that we had to close Unison Live in some way, like in our heads, to give closure to it. And then 25, we will be writing new songs. And we wanted to do that like earlier, but we have been so busy with touring and combining tour even with us with our personal life that still has to keep going too, that we decided to write like after the touring. It's easier.
Yeah.
And I don't like really talk about genres, especially not describing and pigeonholing a band, but you guys match with so many different genres. As you said, you have a few shows in the US with Architects. I've seen you at Rock 'Em Ring, which is a more, let's say, mainstream rock, a bit more open. Now at a punk festival in the Netherlands. Is there a specific fan genre that you feel more comfortable, that welcomes you more? Either the punk side, the heavier side, hardcore like Architects, or the more mainstream side?
I actually have the feeling, and that's something I really like about our band, is that we can play mainstream festivals and it's not strange. We can play heavier metal festivals and it's not strange as well. So it's everywhere we play, we can do all those things, and it's always, everybody's always welcoming, so
we feel very welcome everywhere. But if I'm completely honest, like the true metal scene, it's like a very warm scene. Like we play festivals like Brutal Assault or Grass Pop or Alcatraz or even Download Festival. It's not really a metal festival, but like sometimes I'm surprised that we play those real metal festivals, and people can say a lot about metal that it's like very close society or environment, but it's for us it's not like, we feel very welcome there, and that's cool for a band like Brutus, who is not really a metal band.
Well, I'm enjoying it as well, because now I can see at Rock 'Em Ring and also Brutal Assault and Year on Air, so wherever I go I get a little bit of Brutus. And does it also affect the playlist? You play heavier stuff or more melancholic stuff?
I think the thing that ends up changing the set list the most is the amount of time we get to play. Like for us, if we want to play a really slow, soft song on a metal festival, why not? People in our experiences, I've always been open-minded about it. So it's just set list time. That's
time,
the only thing.
Yeah. Time is the most important for
not the audience.
Were you ever nervous playing to supposedly a brand new genre of fans? And then are they going to accept it? Is it heavy enough for them? Or is it too heavy for them?
No, because history has proven that, and I remember, and Stan will also remember, there was a festival in Hamburg in Germany. And it was called Hell over Hamburg or something. And it was only like metal. And heavy, like
corpse paints.
Real metal. I mean,
And which we love. So,
and it was inside into a closed venue, and we walked into this really special atmosphere, and it was one of the best shows of the tour. Like the people were like cheering so much energy. And since that moment, I was never afraid anymore.
That was for me a moment as well. I was like, oh my god, this is gonna suck so bad.
We were the only people with colored shirts. The only. And it's like, it was nice.
It was really nice, especially after the show in the backstage, all the bands, everybody's just there for the same thing. Good music, whatever it is, doesn't matter. So that's really nice. Yeah.
So would you say that musical purism is dead?
I hope so. I hope so, yeah.
So it's just we evolved, or do you feel like social media affected as well? I feel like TikTok turned it into kind of killed genres. It's just if it sounds good, if it looks good, people listen to it. Yeah. So it's also affecting the metal scene. I feel like even Wacken, that used to be like the heaviest place on earth, also has some pop punk, some alternative, a mixture of everything. So you kind of never know what to expect and you always get a surprise. So is it also affecting your life?
Yeah, I think that's it's a really nice time to be in a band, I think, right now, because you used to, like, years ago, that you were a punk rocker or you were a metalhead, or everything was so separate. Nowadays, people don't give they don't care anymore. And that's a nice thing to see, yeah.
We played Crust Pop Festival last week in Belgium, and it's a huge metal festival in Belgium. And there was a guy with a Killers t-shirt. And I mean, every other shirt was like metal shirt, and he was like not caring, and it's okay. And I like that. I like seeing killer shirts in metal festivals.
I've seen a Taylor Swift concert t-shirt in the mosh pit.
Perfect.
Why not?
Yeah.
I'd love to see you also supporting Taylor Swift and adding some metal to the Swifties' life. That would be interesting as well.
It's going to be fun to watch for people because it's such a big station. The three of us are always close together, so it's going to be like...
What did Dave Grohl said about... Dave Grohl made a statement about Swift this week.
Yeah, he made a statement about we're going to play live.
We're the Errors, not the Errors, but the Errors tour with the Foo Fighters, because we actually make errors because we play live.
Yeah.
Ouch.
Yes. I think there was an open front with the Swifties. always dangerous. We love Swifties. And I would love to see that mixture. Let's talk a little bit about the album that touches on growing up, accepting adulthood. How would you react if I call you adults? Is it something that you like, you accept, you reject?
It's something that I accept that I am, but I really don't feel like it.
Okay.
I think that's the best way I can describe it. Yeah.
In my head, I don't feel as an adult, but in my actions, I sometimes have to act like an adult. So that's
a nice way of putting
that's
it,
true.
Yeah.
And we're both parents too, so we have to be like in some way, sometimes I have to be an adult. I think the album also, like, Stephanie wrote most of the lyrics, but it's also about the struggle. And I think the struggle is real for everybody about adulthood. So.
So on the other side, what's the thing you miss the most about being a kid?
Sleeping in.
You never get that.
I have a 2-year-old, so no. It's over. Done. This morning I got up really early to get here. My daughter was awake already, so no.
It gets better when they're 14.
Oh, still 12 more years to go.
And on that peaceful unison kind of life for the world, I'm going to give you like a pageant queen question.
Okay.
What would you wish for the world? We already talked about purism and genres dying, but the world around us is still crazy. Festival season kind of helps us forget about that for a couple of days. Concerts help us to forget that for a few hours. Tour maybe creates a bubble around you as well, but then we go back to the world and remember we get some news, updates, notifications on our phone. What's that one thing that you think would make the world a bit more unison, a bit more kind to each other?
Small acts of kindness, I think. It's a thing for everybody. I mean, everybody's the same. If everybody wakes up and just starts with small acts of kindness, that's the beginning, I guess.
Stop the war.
Yeah, of course.
Ukraine and Israel, like, I mean, those regions, it's like horrible what's happening there. So, like, just stop that. I think there are other places in the world too, but those are the most
peace
and most up front right now. So. That could stop.
You think music can help with that?
That's a good question.
That's a really good question, yeah.
I don't know. I don't know.
I mean, the rumor was that David Hasselhoff broke down the Berlin Wall. So do you think that music, especially metal, just mosh everyone into one peaceful country or world?
I don't think Putin will listen to metal who wants to change that. I'm afraid that's, I don't know, it's very hard for me, even on my own, when I think about it. What can we do? And we can share stuff on our social media, we can support, and we could put money into a charity fund, and it's still going on. And is it because not enough people do it? Is it because it's not working? I don't know. It's really hard. Really hard question.
Well, I'm going to try and make it a bit more specific to our scene, something that we can all maybe try and do. we're trying to make the metal scene, the music scene in general, more safe, more welcoming for people. Us as three white guys, trying to make it more open for more ethnicities, for more genders, non-binary, trans, people to go in the mosh pit, people to pick up an instrument. From your experience, maybe even sometimes hearing stories through Stephanie's eyes, do you feel like there's something specific that we need to do more or stop completely to make it more welcoming for people to either join us at a party or pick up an instrument and be the next generation that maybe until recently were told, oh, this is not for you?
I think, and speaking not for Stephanie, but like you say, a little bit through her eyes, I think we're a bit Brutus. We were up till this point very lucky. Yeah. And we never felt like bad things happening to Stephanie or to us. And it's always, since the moment we started playing live, we felt very accepted. And also with the girl on stage, we feel very, and she never has been feeling a lot of, maybe 1 to 5 times in 500 shows, that something happened, but it's, yeah, that's it. But I don't want to make the problem smaller. I know it's there. I know
things do have
there.
To change. Yeah, yeah,
the problem
yeah.
is there. But we feel sometimes, I also hear the stories from other bands or other musicians or who tell to me, like, this guy did to me this because I'm a girl. And then I'm like, yeah. It's not like I can do 5 stories with Brutus
no,
like this.
No,
I don't know why.
Me personally, I think you as well. We've always been in bands with women.
Always.
True, yeah. I've never been in a band with just men. And so for me, I mean, I've been in bands with Stephanie since we were 14, 15 years old. That's a long time ago now. So in this modern climate of a lot of things that still need to be done about a lot of things. I mean, for me, it always felt normal of touring and playing in a band with women. And so I've never, we've always been, there's a lot of people around us, the crew and stuff, we're all used to it. So, and still we didn't, there's not a lot we can say about stuff that went wrong or something.
But it's also, like when you ask the question, I think it's hard to talk about. We were three white guys, and it's hard to talk about like racism with three white guys. So for this subject, for me, it's the same. You have to ask the queers and the people, the girls who have bad effects on them.
Yeah, so. Because also for us, it's like we travel so much and we meet so many people. I don't think about somebody's sexual orientation or skin color or stuff. I don't think about it. It's not something we grew up with. It's normal to include everyone for us. But of course, sometimes we see stuff that still need to change. Like, yeah.
I feel like part of the conversation is asking questions, even if you don't have the answers, even if you don't see it all the time. Even three white guys in a very similar scene around us could still ask
you
and
have to
see.
Put it on the agenda.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
So obviously we don't have all the answers. Sometimes we don't have any answers, but still asking and looking around and being aware of the fact that there's something there and there is a discussion is also, I think, bringing a little bit of the change that we want for our friends, our families, people around us. So I appreciate that as well. We said that you guys are going into the studio relatively soon.
Who told you?
I heard that there's some time after the tour, not in September, but once festival season is over, once going to the US, like 2025, which I feel like is around the corner, that's going to be there.
But you still have to...
Yeah, we're going to take most of the year to write the record first.
Okay.
Because we'll be writing, recording it, because you can record a lot ourselves, not final tracks, but that's what we will do in 25, but not like a real album of stuff. It's not coming in.
Okay, great. So you're leading me to my next scoop stealing question.
No worries.
Because Unison Live, your third album, was released in 2022, and we got a live in Ghent in July coming up now, so we're gonna get some live stuff when you go and hide in the studio. Because we're so eager to get more stuff, and I know that the band has a fondness for Scooter, is there going to be a covers EP until the album is out? There's some gushing online. Is that actually the next step before we get the next album?
I don't think so.
No.
It's a good idea.
I really wanted to get a yes on that. Okay,
No,
it's a good idea, though. But
I think we're gonna take our time to write our own stuff.
Yeah.
About a Eurovision song?
No.
Sorry, all good ideas, but.
No.
Okay, so until that happens, we said Live in Ghent coming out July 19th.
But it's a, to be honest, it's a reissue of, it was like, it came in the pandemic.
In finals.
Yeah, this is a reissue because it was sold out like already a long time ago. And I think now, July, it's a reissue of the Live in Ghent album.
Yeah.
So we can enjoy that again while you hide in the US with Architects a little bit and some headline shows, and then in the studio. Apparently not working on a Scooter EP, but still coming up with some great new stuff. Anything else you want to share with fans out there before we say goodbye?
Thanks for coming to the shows.
Yes, thanks for the support.
Yeah.
Not only on the shows, but also when on social media. I know it's only social media, but people are there too. We're all there and we feel a lot of love. And people are sending us DMs and we can't answer everything, but we try. But it's a lot sometimes. And thank you for doing that. We see you. It's not the management something PR dying thing or something, it's us reading all the messages.
Stan and Peter of Brutus, I love the music, cannot wait to see you guys on stage again. Cannot wait for more new music. Thank you much for your time, it's been a pleasure.
Thanks for having us. Thank you.